I'll be talking about you, I'll be talking about WordPress, and I'll also be talking about the community that we are in, all right? So my name is Utsav Singh Rathour. So I am from Nepal, I am a Nepali, so I am talking about WordCamp Kathmandu and not some WordCamp in India, because people tend to confuse me for being an Indian. But yeah, that is a Nepali caste as well, just so you know, clearing that out. So I'm a WordPress enthusiast and a wannabe. I like to call myself a wannabe because I want to be so many different things, and I try to work on that. And you can also follow me on at Rathour or at CodePixels Media. So those are my Twitter handles. If you want to follow me, you could do that over there. Let's get with the topic then. So how many of you are developers over here? By the raise of hands, how many of you are a developer? Okay. And how many of you are non-developers? All right, so we have a good number of non-developers over here. So I just wanted to make sure that you realize that this topic doesn't cover only developers. So I'm talking about contributing to WordPress even if you are not a developer, okay? This topic of mine is still relevant to you if you are not a developer. And I'll be talking about contributing to WordPress in much more different ways than just programming, all right? Okay, sorry. Okay. So it's for everyone. Contributing to WordPress isn't limited to developers or programmers. Contributing to WordPress is for everyone. And there are a lot of ways you can contribute to WordPress, a lot of ways that you didn't even realize were possible, or you didn't even realize that you could contribute to WordPress in that particular format, all right? So moving on, are there any contributors from Nepal? So what the general intention is that if there are people around us who are contributing to something, we tend to get involved easily, rather easily. But if there aren't many, we tend to stay back and do that. So a good question would be, are there any contributors from Nepal? So here's a quick exercise for you guys, okay? So just move your head, take a look around, left, right, left and right. Do you see some people? Right? Everyone sees someone on your right or your left or right in front of you? Right? Congratulations. You've just met, I think, around 50, 55 contributors to WordPress. So congratulations. You have a good network of contributors right here. Okay, moving on. You want to give back to community. I'm talking about giving back to community. But why would you give back to a community when you could be working for some projects, client projects, and making money out of it? Why would you give your precious time and give back to the community? This is one question that I've been always asked. Okay. All right. So there are a few reasons. It takes a team to be where WordPress is right now. Do you know how many websites or what percentage of websites does WordPress power? Right, 60% of the CMS powered websites and 30% of all the websites, or maybe it was top 1 million websites in the world, is powered by WordPress. Now that is a huge number. 30% means we are the industry leaders. WordPress is the industry leader. But if it would have been only Matt Mullenberg or some two or three more developers, WordPress wouldn't be where it is today. It is because of us, we people, that WordPress now powers so many people, so many websites, okay? And it always pays to give back, always. So when you say it always pays you back, what I mean is you're not necessarily getting back the money that you've invested in the sense of time, but you'll always get a lot more than what is worth, more than money. So that is what is important. Okay, but where do I start? You want to contribute to WordPress, you want to know how you can contribute to WordPress and get along with it, but you don't know where to start. So contributing starts right here, right in this WordCamp. You can start contributing right here in this particular WordCamp itself. Or if you want to officially contribute, you can go to make.wordpress.org. Like Nizam said a while ago, you can create a profile on make.wordpress.org and then start contributing. There is an advantage of making a profile on make.wordpress.org and contributing. I'll show that in a while. Okay, so how else apart from programming? Like, we all know we can code and then contribute to WordPress, but how do you contribute without coding? That is what we're going to talk about today. All right, so let me start with a few of the items that we can do. So the first one is speak up at WordCamps or meetups. So like what I'm doing right now is I'm contributing to WordPress. What I'm doing is I'm sharing what I know of WordPress and how I can make WordPress better with you guys so that you can start contributing to WordPress as well. In a way, I'm contributing to WordPress to make it better so that more and more people are getting involved in it. So that is one way you can contribute. So one way is speak at events or meetups. The other one is translate. Now, I have a quick question. How many of you know what is read more called in Nepali? Read more like Nepali ma bhannu parne ke bhannu parcha? Pura bhannus athwa aru koi? Anyone else? Read more like Nepali ma ke bhancha? Hai dherai padhnus pura padhnus ke bhancha ni ta. So tyo thaha chha ni ta. So you could be translating to, you can contribute to WordPress. Do you know that WordPress is 100% translated into Nepali? You could use WordPress as Nepali CMS tool as well. Kasalai Nepali mai chalaun sajil lagcha bhane chai Nepali ma pani WordPress use garna milcha. So, and WordPress can be used in many other languages. So what is that, what does that mean? That is, many people who can translate WordPress to their particular language can translate WordPress, and that is contributing as well. The other one is documentation. Like, there will be times when we want some help on WordPress, where we are stuck, where we don't know what we need to do. And then when we go to Codex or maybe some support forums or anywhere we go, we do not find enough documentation for that particular theme or for that particular plugin or even core WordPress as well. You think you can make make some changes, you think you can suggest something else or write a documentation for that, you can do that. That means you have just made documentation for WordPress better in that one particular thing. So you've contributed to WordPress. So next time anyone has the same kind of problem, they can refer to you, your page that you've published, and they can get help. So that is documentation, and that way you're making WordPress better. Now, if you, how many of you have had problems while creating a website using WordPress? We have been stuck at times, right? What is the best thing about WordPress? The best thing about WordPress is that there is a lot of help available online. So you can always go to any website or forums and seek help. So you can do that. Another one is support. You can go to some forums or WordPress's default forum and you can answer some unanswered questions. You can help people with who are stuck somewhere. You can help fix their issues, and everyone who later on faces the same kind of problem can refer to your support ticket and have their problem fixed. Another way is training. Like whenever you teach someone how to use WordPress, or whenever you teach someone how to code in WordPress, or whenever you teach someone how to make a website in WordPress, you are training someone. That means you are creating one more person who uses WordPress, who will be using, who will be a future WordPress user, and who will continue to work on WordPress. You're helping a community become even stronger. If you're training 10 people, you're adding 10 people to the community, which is already this big. So that means the community keeps growing bigger. You can always train someone and make, contribute to WordPress. The other one is contribute to core. Now, contributing to core is easy as well. It isn't as difficult as you'd, one would think. You don't necessarily have to code everything, or you don't necessarily have to know code in, and become a senior developer to contribute to the core. In fact, there are cases when there are core developers who have fixed an issue in WordPress that was, that was as simple as adding, pointing out that there was a missing comma, or there was a missing license for a particular image that was used in WordPress. So you ask them to add a license, you've helped contribute to the core. So it's easy as that. You don't always have to code. Another one is organizing meetups and WordCamps, just like this one. You don't have to always organize a WordCamps. You can do meetups, you can meet. You don't even have to do it officially. Like you could be five of your friends who use WordPress, meet up, talk about it, and figure things out, help each other. Those kind of things help as well. As many people that get educated with WordPress or know how to use WordPress or know how to make a website in WordPress, that means we're only growing the community. The community only becomes bigger and better. Then there's reviewing themes that Nizam talked about as well. So you can review themes. You can help others create better themes and make the WordPress theme repository a better one. And we also have a key reviewer in-house, Sandilya. So he's there. He's the key reviewer. There are two or three key reviewers at a time, and we have one from Nepal. So in throughout the WordPress community, there's only two or three key reviewers at a time, and we have Sandilya. Sandilya, could you please stand up? So yeah, he's a key reviewer as well. We had Nilambar before, and before that we had Sakin Shrestha as well. Nilambar isn't here, and Sakin Shrestha is probably outside. You can meet them as well, all right? They have been key reviewers. So that's the highest position that there is for theme reviewers. Then there's WordPress TV. Like others said, you can watch it in WordPress.tv. Everything that's done here will be presented to WordPress TV. So what does that mean is anyone who wants to attend any topic that they find interesting, that they cannot come to that particular WordCamp, they can find it in WordPress.tv. So WordCamp poker organizers will be helping others who want to attend some topics that were discussed here by putting it in WordPress.tv. Another thing is, say you want to add subtitles, maybe translate the presentation into Nepali or maybe some other languages. You could do that as well. That is contributing as well, because as many languages there are, there will be a lot more people involved. So that's one way. The other one is make WordPress and websites accessible. Now this is an important thing as well. How many of you understand what making a website accessible means? Can you raise your hands? Okay, quite a few people. So do you know that there are WordPress users and WordPress developers who cannot see at all? Who cannot see, if they see it, they cannot use it properly, and there are a lot more things involved. So even they can code a website in WordPress. We had one person in WordCamp Kathmandu as well, who gave us a talk on making websites accessible. He couldn't see it, see what was happening on the screen, but he would be making websites in WordPress. Now that is the power of WordPress. You don't necessarily have to see what you're making, because WordPress is accessible. And if you can, if you're contributing it by making themes or plugins, you can make it accessible so that everything happens for good and everyone can use it. Everyone can create a website using your theme or plugin or anything as such. All right? And there are a lot more ways. I just listed out 10. There are a lot more ways on make.wordpress.org. Go visit the site, make.wordpress.org, and you'll find out different ways to help and different ways to give back to the community and how you can do that and what all the processes are. All right. 30% of the world's websites, because of people like us who have been contributing to WordPress, who have been contributing to the core, to the creating free themes, plugins, doing WordCamps, speaking at WordCamps, all those things. If it wasn't for people like us, people like you, people like me, WordPress probably wouldn't be where it is right now. People traveling from, like we have our friends coming from Bangladesh, from India, from Japan, all for the love of WordPress. So WordPress is the most loved CMS because of people like us. And like I said, also pays back. This is a WordPress.org profile badge, all right? So you get recognized for what you do. I review themes, I have a theme review team badge, I'm a WordCamp organizer, I have a badge for that. It lets people know that are visiting your profile that you are a core contributor or you are a theme reviewer or you're giving back to the community in one way or the other. All right, so let's make WordPress better then. All right, thank you. That's about it for me. And if there are any questions, you can ask right here. Based on anything, if there's anything else that you'd want to rather discuss outside, I can do that as well. Thank you.
Hello. I have a question for you.
Yeah, sure.
How we can motivate to new WordPressers to contribute in WordPress? Do you have any tips that a fresher can also contribute in WordPress? Or if they are thinking about from where I can begin, can you please give them some tips so that they can start contributing in WordPress?
Yes, thank you. Thank you for the question. So there is, in fact, a way. In WordCamp Kathmandu 2019, to be, we are having a contribution day like we had in WordCamp Kathmandu 2018, where we'll be selecting a few niches where we'll be trying to contribute. So last time we contributed on theme review, on documentation, on translation, and all those things. So we're trying to do that as well in WordCamp Kathmandu 2019. So you can start from there. If you cannot be in WordCamp Kathmandu 2019, you can always go to make.wordpress.org and you can create a profile. You have documentations for each team. You have handbooks for each team. You can go through them. You can learn how you can get started on contributing back to the community. All right, thank you.